Hello students, welcome to our channel. Today we want to talk about the topic known as chemical families, patterns and properties. This is the second chapter in form two, that is chemical properties. And we have to also talk about the patterns and their properties as well. As you studied in the first chapter of form two, that is the structure of the atom on the periodic table, we talked about the categorizing of the 20 elements in the periodic table, and we categorized it into two. That is now according to their respective groups and according to their respective periods. And when we were talking about the group, we say when you want to group them according to the respective groups, you have to check the valence electrons, and when it comes to the period, you have to check the number of occupied energy levels. So in this topic now, the elements that are in the same group, they can be termed as in the same chemical family. Therefore, in this chapter, we are going to talk about in detail four chemical families. That is the group 1 elements, the group 2 elements, the group 7 elements, and the group 8 elements. And in today's lesson, we want to talk about the first group, that is the group 1 elements. In this chapter, we are going to cover the group 1 elements as the first lesson, which are also known as the alkali metals or the alkali metals. In every case that you can pronounce it, okay? So in the first chapter, in form 2, we talked about the group 1 elements, and we know that in the group 1 elements we have 3 elements, that is lithium, sodium and potassium, and we know their electronic configurations. That is, when it comes to lithium, it has an electronic configuration of 2-1. When it comes to sodium, it has an electronic configuration of 2-8-1. When it comes to potassium, it has an electronic configuration of 2-8-8-1. Therefore, when we check the electron arrangement of these three elements in the group 1 of the periodic table, that is now the alkali metals, in the outermost energy level, they have one electron. That is now they have one valence electron in the outermost energy level. Therefore, we can say lithium, sodium, and potassium belong to the same group, as well as they belong to the same chemical family, since they belong to the same group. But again, if we check the number of occupied energy levels, they differ. When it comes to lithium, it has 2 occupied energy levels. When it comes to sodium, it has 3 occupied energy levels. And when it comes to potassium, it has 4 occupied energy levels. Therefore, they belong to different periods. That is, lithium belongs to period 2, sodium belongs to period 3, and potassium belongs to period 4. But when it comes to the grouping, we have to check the valence electron. That is the outermost electron in the outermost energy level. Lithium, it has 1, sodium 1, and potassium 1. Since all of them, they have one valence electron in their structure, we can say lithium, sodium, and potassium, they belong to the same group. Therefore, they also belong to the same chemical family known as the alkali metals. Therefore now, from that point, we can go further and discuss about the atomic size and the ionic size of these three elements in the alkali metals. So we have to talk about the gradation in size of atom and ion. Before we proceed to the explanation regarding the size of the atom and the ion, we are supposed to understand the definition of an atom. We are also supposed to understand the definition of an ion. In form 1, we define atom as the smallest particle of an element that can take part in a chemical reaction. We also talked about ion in the first chapter, that is the structure of the atom and the periodic table during ion formation. And we see ion is the third particle that is formed when an electron gains or loses electrons. Therefore now, When it comes to the size of the atom and ion in the group 1 elements, that is now the alkali metals, they differ. But the question is the atomic radius greater or the ionic radius greater? But before even we compare, we are supposed to understand the definition of atomic radius, and we are also supposed to understand the definition of ionic radius. We have two terms here. What is atomic radius? Atomic radius is the distance between the nucleus of an atom and the outermost energy level occupied by electron or electrons. We can demonstrate it by drawing, and we can say that this is assumed, this is the structure of the atom, and it has several energy levels, but now at the center we have the nucleus. Therefore, the distance between the nucleus and the outermost energy level, this is now what we call the atomic radius. The distance between the nucleus of an atom and the outermost energy level occupied by electron or electrons, that is the definition of atomic radius. And when it comes to ionic radius is the distance between the nucleus of an ion and the outermost energy level and the outermost energy level occupied by electron or electrons. So when you're defining atomic radius and ionic radius, what is going to guide you is this atomic and this ionic. When you're talking about atomic, you have to state the nucleus of an atom. And when you're talking about ionic radius, you have to talk about the nucleus of an ion. But now, we are supposed to compare the electronic configuration or the electron arrangement of the atoms of the group 1 elements and the ions of group 1 elements. As you see here, we already have the electron arrangement for the atoms of the group 1 elements. And we know lithium, the formula is like that. For sodium, it is natrium, and this is the chemical symbol. And for potassium, it's calcium, that is the chemical symbol. But when it comes to the ions of group 1 elements, as we know, during ion formation, group 1 elements loses the outermost electron to attain stability. Lithium, having 2-1, will lose the outermost electron to attain a duplet configuration state, that is 2. Sodium, having 2-8-1, will lose the valence electron to attain a stability, having an electronic configuration of 2-8. For potassium, it has 2-8-8-1, and it loses the outermost electron to attain stability and having an electronic configuration of 2-8-8. That is now for lithium ion is 2, sodium ion having 2-8, and potassium ion having 2-8-8. Therefore, we can deduce from here that when group 1 elements undergoes ion formation, they lose the outermost electron to attain stability, and they will form an ion known as a cation. That is now positively charged ion. So since now we have understood what an atom means, what an ion means, and the definition of atomic radius and ionic radius, now we are in a position to compare the atomic radius and the ionic radius of the group 1 elements, that is now the alkali metals. So if you check lithium, sodium, and potassium, the electronic configuration of the atoms, lithium, it has 2 energy levels, the lithium atom. But if you compare it with the lithium ion, it has only 1 energy level, When it comes to sodium atom, it has three energy levels. Sodium ion, it has two energy levels. If you compare potassium atom, it has four energy levels, but now potassium ion, it has three energy levels. From here, we can realize that lithium atom has the least number of occupied energy levels, whereas potassium, it has more number of occupied energy levels compared to the others. Therefore now, as you go down the group, from lithium to sodium to potassium, there is increase in the atomic size. The atomic radius increases from lithium to sodium to potassium. As you go down the group, the atomic radius increases. Now the question is, why is it increasing? This is because of the increase in the number of electrons. When the number of electrons increases, there will be an increase in the number of occupied energy levels. That is the reason as to why the atomic size is increasing. Let us compare. Lithium, it has three electrons. Sodium, it has 11 electrons. And potassium, it has 19 electrons. So as you go down the group, the number of electrons are increasing. If the number of electrons increases, this means the number of occupied energy levels are also going to increase. Therefore, as you go down the group, the atomic radius increases. Let us go to the ion. When it comes to the ion, lithium, it has two electrons. Sodium ion, it has 10 electrons. And when it comes to potassium ion, it has 18 electrons. So if we compare the electrons, lithium, it has two. Sodium ion, it has 10 electrons. And potassium ion, it has 18 electrons. So as you go down the group, the number of electrons are increasing. This will similarly increase the number of occupied energy levels. Therefore, we can deduce that as you go down the group, the ionic radius increases. So at this point, we have understood that for the atomic radius, it is increasing down the group, and the ionic radius, it is also increasing down the group. But the question is, between the atomic radius and the ionic radius, which one is greater? As you know, when we talk about ion formation, there is losing of electron. When the group one element loses the outermost electron, the remaining electrons will experience a greater nuclear charge. This greater nuclear charge is going to cause the remaining electrons to be attracted towards the nucleus. As that now occurs, this will reduce the size of the ion, and hence we can deduce that the atomic radius is greater than the ionic radius. That is now the gradation in the size of the atom and the ion. So generally we can summarize as atomic radius is greater than the ionic radius because during ion formation the ion the atom will lose the outermost electron, and this causes a greater nuclear charge to occur between the remaining electrons and the nucleus. Hence, the remaining electrons are attracted towards the nucleus, thus decreasing the size of the ion. Hence, the ionic radius is smaller than the atomic radius. In the physical properties of the group 1 elements, we are going to talk about the appearance, the ease of cutting, the melting and boiling points, the electrical conductivity and ionization energy. Generally, for the appearance of the group 1 elements, you are supposed to understand that the alkali metals, they have what we call a shiny metallic luster. They are shiny gray. Therefore, they have a shiny metallic luster. That is their appearance. But the question is the shiny metallic luster, a protective layer that cannot be oxidized? The question is no. Why? Because when alkali metals are exposed to air, this surface is going to tarnish quickly. The surface tarnishes when it is exposed to air, because it reacts with air. So there, let's go to the ease of cutting. For the ease of cutting, as you go down the group from lithium to sodium to potassium, the ease of cutting increases down the group. Ease of cutting increases. But the question is, why is it increasing? Because, as you see, lithium, it has 2 energy levels, sodium 3 energy levels, and potassium 4 energy levels. And this now we talked about it in the atomic gradient. We say, as you go down the group, the atomic size is increasing because of the increase in the number of electrons, which will cause an increase in the number of occupied energy levels. Therefore now, when it comes to the ease of cutting, how to cut now? When it comes to cutting of lithium, when it comes to cutting of sodium, and when it comes to cutting of potassium can be easily cut when it comes to sodium. Sodium can also be easily cut when it comes to lithium. The question is why? This is because as you go down the group, the atomic size increases. As the atomic size increases, there will be weakening of forces of attraction. As the atomic size increases, the forces of attraction will weaken. Why? Because the outermost electron is loosely held by the positive nucleus. If it is loosely held, therefore this means the element can be easily cut. Therefore, as you go down the group, the ease of cutting in alkali metals increases down the group. This is because, proceed now to the next physical property. That is now the melting and boiling point. Still, we are going to use the same electronic configuration. When it comes to the melting and boiling point, we can see they still differ in the number of occupied energy levels. As we go down the group, the number of occupied energy levels are increasing. This means the outermost electron is loosely held in potassium than in sodium. Also, the valence electron in sodium is loosely held compared to that of lithium. Therefore, this melting and boiling point that we want is the amount of energy required to remove electron from the structure of an alkali metal. Therefore now, as we go down the group, the melting point and boiling point increase. As you go, because we see a potassium atom, the outermost electron is loosely held. If it is loosely held, it requires small amount of heat energy, so that the process of attraction can be broken down. When it comes to sodium, having a smaller size compared to potassium, will require a higher melting point, so that the process of attraction can be broken. When it comes to lithium, having a smaller size compared to sodium again, will require a higher melting and boiling point, so that the process of attraction can be broken. Therefore now, from this we can understand that lithium is having stronger forces of attraction than sodium and potassium, as well as sodium is having a stronger force of attraction compared to potassium. Potassium, having the largest atomic size, will have the weakest forces of attraction. If the forces of attraction are weak in potassium, this means it will require a lower melting and boiling point. Therefore, we can summarize as you go down the group in group 1 elements, that is from lithium to sodium to potassium, the melting point and boiling point decreases. Let us check again the electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity. It can also be the same as thermal conductivity. The ability of a substance to conduct both heat and electricity. From this structure, the electron arrangement that we have for lithium, sodium, and potassium, as you see, they have one valence electrons in the outermost energy level. This valence electron in the structures of group 1 elements, they are free to move. That means they are random. Hence, we refer to them as the localized electron. It is called delocalized electron. If the electron is delocalized, this means it is not in a fixed position. It has the ability to move. Therefore, if alkali metals, they have a delocalized electron, then they are said to be good conductors of both heat and electricity because of ionization energy. Ionization energy is the minimum amount of energy, is the minimum amount of energy required to remove, an electron from the outermost energy level, from the outermost energy level of an atom in its gaseous state, That is the complete definition for ionization energy. Is the minimum amount of energy required to remove an electron from the outermost energy level of an atom in its gaseous state. We know lithium atom, it has 2-1, sodium atom, it has 2-8-1, and potassium atom, it has 2-8-8-1. From this, we know that alkali metals, they lose the valence electron in the structure to attain stability. Therefore, during ion formation, lithium, sodium, and potassium, they lose one electron from their structure. When they are going to lose that electron, they will require an energy so that they can lose that electron. Therefore, that energy is called ionization energy. So, when it comes to alkali metals, we are going to just discuss about something we call the first ionization energy. What is this first ionization energy? The first ionization energy is the minimum amount of energy required to remove the first electron from the outermost energy level of an atom in its gaseous state. We also have the second ionization energy to remove now the second electron, and that one we are going to explain it further in the group two elements, that is the alkaline earth metals. But for now, we are just going to discuss about the first ionization energy. This is the minimum amount. We are supposed to understand that as we go down the group, the ionization energy, is it going to increase or is it going to decrease? The ionization energy decreases, decreases down the group. Why is it decreasing? This is because as you go down the group, the atomic size is increasing. If the atomic size increases, this makes the outermost electron to be loosely held by the positive nucleus. If it is loosely held, this means it will require a small amount of energy so that it can be lost. Therefore now, lithium, its outermost electron is firmly held by the positive nucleus. But when it comes to sodium, since the outermost electron is far away from the nucleus, the forces of attraction will become weak. In potassium, the outermost electron or the valence electron is far away from the nucleus compared to sodium. Therefore, the forces of attraction in potassium is weakest, but in sodium is a bit stronger than potassium. And in lithium, it is the strongest. Therefore, now, as we go down the group, the atomic size is increasing. This will cause an increase in the, this will cause a decrease in the forces of attraction holding the atoms together. Therefore, there will be a decrease in the ionization energy as we go down the group. That is now the physical properties of alkali metals. Let us proceed. Alkali metals, their chemical constitution. Salam alaikum.